What's up, guys? My name is Aaron, and welcome back to my channel where we talk about building wealth and building you through investing. Now, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more content like this every single week. Today, we're diving into moving averages, how you can use them to better your trading, and what you need to know about moving averages to gain the most out of them. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to apply these moving averages to your charts. I'm going to show you how to use moving averages to follow the trend. I'm also going to show you how to use moving averages to control your portfolio exposure to make sure you're not too invested or underinvested at the right or wrong time. Moving averages are basically just a measure to show a trend. How they work is they take the price of whatever the underlying stock is and they average it over a set amount of days that you set. So for example, the 200-day moving averages, which is a really common moving average on almost every single chart, is the average price of the underlying security averaged over 200 days, and it's displayed as a line. And I'll dive into that in a few moments and show you exactly what I'm talking about. So the first reason to use a moving average is to identify the trend. So on my charts, I have these four moving averages, ranging from the 8-day to the 200-day, to show me the average price for different time periods. So the second reason that I love moving averages is as a metric to control portfolio exposure. So a perfect trend would be when the 8-day is on the top, then you have the 21-day, then you have the 50-day, then you have the 200-day. So in a perfect uptrend, it gives you the opportunity to apply leverage in your portfolio. The beauty of this though is when things start to get a little tricky. So now let's say the 8-day crosses the 21-day. This is a signal to you to maybe reduce portfolio exposure off leverage for sure, and maybe down to 75%. So I know you probably love hearing me talk about this all day, but it's even better if I jump into my computer and I can show you. All right, guys, so let's jump in and learn about some moving averages. So the first thing that I'm gonna show you how to do is how to add these moving averages to your chart. I'm using Thinkorswim right now, but it'll be relatively the same across any platform. So what you're gonna wanna do is navigate right here to the Edit Studies button. This pulls up the Edit Studies box, and you can see here that I already have added four simple moving averages. But to add these, just find the search box, type in simple moving average, and then you'll see this right here, simple moving average. And basically just double click that and it'll pop over here. So you see I have four moving averages selected right now. The 8-day, 21-day, 50-day, and 200-day. So in order to get these different time frames, you're gonna need to edit the simple moving average. So the next step that you need to do is navigate to the settings wheel within the simple moving average. And then you see the length input right here, 21 days. This is where you're gonna wanna edit the amount of time that your simple moving average is using to calculate the average. So right here, we have 21 days. So that's all it is. You're editing the amount of days that the simple moving average is using to calculate the average. Now we're into the good stuff. Let's zoom in on this chart right here. So you can see that I have four moving averages right here. The green one is the 8-day, the purple one is the 21-day, the blue one is the 50-day, and the red one is the 200-day. So let's zoom in on this perfect uptrend right here. You see that we have the 8-day, the green line, all the way at the top, meaning over the past 8 days, the stock has been trading up above the 8-day moving average very consistently. Then we have the 21-day right under that, over the past 21 days, still trending up, and then 50, 200 days. So as a general rule of thumb, it's much easier to trade stocks that are trading in a positive direction. So if you're trading stocks above the 200-day, you know that that stock over the past 200 days has been trading in an upwards direction. You can see right here, we broke the 200-day, and we still haven't regained that. So this stock, the SPY, is technically still in a downtrend. So now let's move over to the second reason why I love moving averages, which is as a metric to control your portfolio exposure, and really a great measure to help you reduce risk and add risk at the right times. All right, guys, so this is the 2000 bear market. So you can see this was a severe bear market. I mean, it lasted a couple of years, basically fell 50%, cut your portfolio in half. Let's jump back to moving averages and see how they would have helped you in this situation if you followed a simple metric to reduce portfolio exposure as moving averages crossed. So as a quick refresher, you remember the green line right here is your 8-day, purple is your 21-day, blue is your 50-day, red is your 200-day. So right here, as the green line, the 8-day, crosses the 21-day, that was really your first sell signal. That was the first sell signal to reduce portfolio exposure by some percentage. 8-day crosses the 21-day, reduce exposure by 25%. Then we move a little further, the 21-day crosses the 50-day, reduce exposure again by 25%. Then the 50-day crossed the 200-day. This is significant. This shows you that the longer-term trend is starting to turn and trend lower. Now, I would like to be 25% invested here because it's showing a longer-term downtrend is starting to form. So now you can see that throughout this entire bear market, the 50-day never crossed above the 200-day, not once, until right here. This is when the longer-term trend showed that it's starting to form an uptrend and is really showing you that an uptrend is taking way. But during this process, you can see that the shorter moving averages, they cross each other all the time. So let's move back to the top. And let's still follow the green 8-day moving average. You're following the same metrics, just in reverse. So if the 8-day crosses the 21-day, you're gonna wanna add 25% worth of exposure. All right, we cross below again, reduce that exposure. And basically keep following this. And then right here, you can see that the 21-day cross the 50-day. Now you should be 75% invested because first the 8-day crosses the 21-day right here. That was your measure to get 50% invested. Then the 21-day crosses the 50-day. Now you should be back up to 75% because who knows, it might have ended and continued up over here. But clearly that didn't happen. But then, okay, the 8-day and 21-day both roll over. Boom, reduce exposure right here, back to 25%. Then you follow it down. See, 8-day never crosses above the 21-day. You should not have added any exposure until right here. 8-day crosses above the 21-day. Now you should be back to 50% invested. 21-day crosses the 50-day. Right here, 75% invested. Then right here, 8-day crosses 21-day, reduce exposure again. 21-day crosses the 50-day, reduce exposure again. But the big takeaway throughout this entire bear market is that the 50-day never crossed above the 200-day. A long-term trend, a long-term uptrend was never established. So you should have never been 100% or more invested until you get right here. This is a key moment. This is when when all the moving averages are trending in the right direction. The 8-day is up top, followed by the 21-day, followed by the 50-day, followed by the 200-day. Meaning that the short-term trend is moving up and the long-term trend is starting to form an uptrend. This is really when it starts to get safe to be 100% invested or more. Here, I would have liked to be more than 100% invested. Generally, when we have this perfect uptrend, I like to be more than 100% invested, up to 300% invested. And the biggest takeaway from using moving averages to control exposure is that it's a metric to control how your portfolio's capital is allocated. So here's another representation of what I mean about how to use moving averages to control portfolio exposure. Let's just run through this again. So if the 8-day is crossing above the 21-day, and the 21-day is above the 50-day, and the 50-day is above the 200-day, then you should be 100% or more invested, at least for my taste. This is all according to how I like to trade. And then 8-day crosses below the 21-day, but the 21-day is still above the 50-day, the 50-day is still above the 200-day, you should be 75 to 100% invested. But then as the 8-day is now lower than the 21-day and the 21-day is lower than the 50-day, but the 50-day is still above the 200-day, then you should be 50% invested. Then finally, this would be a full downtrend. The 8-day is below the 21-day, 21-day is below the 50-day, 50-day is below the 200-day, then you should be 25% invested, such as right here. And just do the reverse of this to get invested on the way out. So that was pretty cool, right? Now you know how to use moving averages to control your portfolio exposure and to gain an edge on others. Definitely throw these on your charts, give them a try. You have nothing to lose and see how you like them. All right, guys, that's it for me. Make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.